Welcome everybody to part 4 of assembling the Ultimaker Original Plus 3D printer. Tonight we're going to install the Z stage, which is the part that goes up and down under the extruder and holds the part that you're going to be building. So what we need tonight to start with is the base plate of the Z stage, which I show here. These two bearings come in their own plastic wrappers. One's going to go here. One's going to go over here. And this time we're going to use these fat guys. These are M4 screws, not M3s. We've been using M3s so far. So there's 8 M4 screws, 8 M4s that are 10 millimeters long, and 6 M3s that are 10 millimeters long. This is the strain relief clip, and you're also going to need the Z-Stage translation bearing, which as it comes shipped from the folks at Ultimaker, comes on the Z-motor. That's this piece here. So I'm going to pull it off so we can assemble it. And there we go. Now you notice here, and on my version of the kit, and in all the recent ones, the base plate is symmetric. The holes are symmetric, the bevels around the edges are symmetric, it doesn't matter which way we put it. In some of the earlier kits, there was a tab sticking off here, and these two holes didn't exist. But we're not going to worry about that tonight because we have the current version. So I'll start by installing the vertical bearings. Now for this you're going to need a 2.5 millimeter Allen key, like this. And it's pretty straightforward. Just drop the screw through and thread it into the base plate. Don't force it. You can easily cross-thread this. I always like to do it in a star pattern, so I'm going to go for the one on the opposite corner. Shouldn't have to force it. It's a fairly tight thread, but you easily cross thread it, so just take your time. Okay, got all four of those started and in pretty good, so I'm going to go over here and get on with the next one. Okay, now that I've got all of them in, I'm going to snug them down. As you know, I like to use a star pattern. Four-pointed star in this case. Do the first tightening with the little end up in the air. Come back and give it a good tighten with the long handle. Okay, got our vertical bearings in. Now we're going to install the drive nut assembly. It's symmetric, so it doesn't matter which way you put it. But it goes into this hole like this. It doesn't like to fit so well. It's going to be tightened down. So it's important that you line up the holes properly. need to use the driver. Again, it should just thread right in. No argument. Here, star pattern is very important to seat it down well. I can see the flange is coming down. I'm going to keep going. Got a little bit of a gap left there. That's one time through my star pattern. Looking a little snugger, but we're not all the way down yet. So let's do it again. The nice thing about using a star pattern is when you go back, they're loose again on the other corners. Okay. Now you can see it's completely snug. But I'm going to go over it again just to make sure. Alright, the next step is to install the heater bed. You can see we finished our Z stage here. This is the heater bed. You can see the electrical connections there. These wires are what do the heating. This is the cable for the heater bed. Came in your kit. We also have, still holding on to our cable retainer here, we have four countersunk 8mm M3 screws. Four lock washers and two glass clips that'll hold the glass on top of the heater plate. So the way we're going to do this is we're going to flip this heater over, and we're going to notice that we have countersunk screws here on the back. So the way the glasses clip work is that we're going to put these on so that they hold the glass down on the bare aluminum like this. So for each of these, we're going to use a pair of lock washers. So the countersunk screw goes through like this. The lock washer goes on the back like this. I'm not going to tighten it down yet. We'll get there. Next countersunk screw comes in. Well, you know you have this right because the countersunk screws are going to be smooth with the surface of the aluminum so we can clip the glass plate underneath there. Therefore, we want the glass clips holes to be on the bottom side, opposite away from the countersunk screws. So let's do the other side. This is the other corner here. Again, it's the same thing. Countersunk screw through the hole in the glass clip. Put on a lock nut. It's one. Then second one. Now we'll tighten them down. We'll just use pliers and hold them from the back. And then it's our standard 2mm nut driver. I haven't tightened them all the way yet. There's a little bit of looseness there. Do the other side. Once we make sure we got everything in the right place, we'll go back and tighten it all down. Now you can see we have glass clips in place on the back of the heater plate. Okay, now you can see I'm attaching the wiring to the heater plate. There's two pairs of wires, two blacks, two grays. I've already attached the gray, and here you can see I'm using a small jeweler screwdriver to do it because these are small screws. Now I'm going to insert and attach the black wires. It doesn't matter which order you put the wires in, as long as you separate the gray and the black and follow the procedure there. So you can see I'm pushing the cable harness over. I've got the black ones in, so now I'm going to tighten down these four screws. These two screws, excuse me. Okay, there's that one. Give it a good tighten. This is a good moving stage. It's going to have some wires pulling on them. We want them to be nice and snug in there. Okay. So we've got our wires attached. They feel really firm. Let me go back and check the tightness one more time on each one of them. All right, now we've attached the wire harness to the heater plate. All right, now comes the fun part. We're going to put the heater bed and the glass plate here onto the Z stage. And the way we're going to do it is we're going to use these parts here. These knurled nuts are going to come up from the bottom with a spring, which we have three of each, and these washers. And we're going to thread these countersunk nuts down into it to hold everything in place. So to start out with, we need to put some copper grease. And so this can be kind of messy. Here's our high temperature copper grease. What we're going to do is just cut a corner off of it so we can keep it from going everywhere. So I'm going to just take my scissors and cut a little corner off like that. See the grease starting to come out. Then we're going to take the washers. If you look at them, the one side is curved on the top. The other side's completely flat on the bottom. We want to put the grease on the top part where it can rub the bottom of the heater assembly. So I'm just going to take the grease and just sort of rub it on the front side of the washer like this, and then put the washer down onto the knurled nut like this. Again, we'll touch it up with a little more grease. Okay, that's one. Don't be shy with the paper towels. Okay, here comes the next one. Likewise. Put the grease right on there like that. Don't need a lot, just enough. And then the third one. And go with the grease. Again, you want the curved side of the washer up. Let's make sure we get enough on every one. Okay. Now we'll do a little cleanup. We're going to need more of this copper grease later, so we'll wrap it up and save it. The heater's going to go this way with the aluminum plate facing up. So one of the first things we want to do is take our clip, which we've been hanging on to, and thread the cable through it. Then use these two 10 millimeter screws. And attach the strain relief clip down to the stage like this. Oops. You don't want to tighten it until we get everything in position. What we're doing now is starting the threads to hold the cable in place. That's the first step. And we can pull it back. You can see where our countersunk screws are going to go. So now, take each of these assemblies, a knurl nut with a washer on it, and we'll drop the base plate down onto it, like so. A little grease there, it's fine. Wipe it off. And do the same with the next one. This front corner here. Two. And then the third one goes back here. Underneath the bottom, you can see it right there. So I've got all three of them in place. Now I'm going to use the set screws along with these countersunk guys to do the attaching. I'll do the back one first. This is pretty straightforward. Just take the countersunk screw, go down through the spring like that. Use our driver to thread it in. Okay, now that we've got this one holding everything in place, we'll do the front two. And it's the same thing. You put the spring on top of the nut like this, only this time we're going to add the glass clip. Now again, it's going to rotate, so imagine the glass clip like this. It's going to go through the hole here. So I'm going to take my countersunk 20 millimeter. I'm going to go through the hole, through the glass clip, and then through the spring, and start threading it in. Don't tighten them down yet. Same thing over here. Insert the spring first. Then we're going to put the glass clip. Again, check the orientation. The clip goes on top, the outer hole, like this. Now we're going to take the screw, put it through. Now we're ready to install the glass plate. You can see the glass plate is wrapped in this nice plastic wrapper. And you can also see that it has a warning hot decal on that. And we want to put that towards the front because it's trying to warn us. And so you can see here, the glass clips are on the front. These are shipping clips. They come off. Take all four of them off. It's just to keep us from breaking when we're shipping. And we're going to line it up with the stage and go under the glass clip from the back, one side at a time. Make sure it's even. And then we're going to do the same thing on the front. We're going to bring our glass clips on like this. And now we've installed the glass onto the extruder stage. So we're going to need some wooden parts for this next piece. This is the heater controller. You can see it bends like this. We also need these four parts, the sides of it, and you can see where the wood's going to bend over, like that. Okay, along with that we have six 12 millimeter screws, four 14 millimeter screws, and 10 nuts. Okay, so now we're going to assemble this back part. And we want the Ultimaker loco to be facing the right way outward, so we're going to flip it over upside down. And we're going to start with these middle parts here. Now they go, they're both the same, and they go into these holes here. One goes here. One goes here. And you can remember my technique about holding a nut in the pliers to get it in the right orientation. So I'm going to use needle nose this time because it's a little close. So here I'm taking the nut and I'm going to insert it into the hole, and this is going to be a 14 millimeter coming up from the bottom here. Cinch it down. Don't tighten it all the way yet. Same thing on the other side. And we start out with our pliers to hold the nut like that. We insert, goes right in. Come up with our bolt from the bottom. Okay, so we got two middle pieces in place. Now we're going to bend this around to do the same thing. So let's start by putting our nuts. Put one on this side. These are a little tighter. Grip them firmly and shove them in like that. Same thing on the other side. And we're going to bend the part around this time and come with the 14 millimeters again. They go screwing right in. One. The other one comes from this side. Now that we got all four of them, we can tighten them down. Middle pieces are installed, and now we're going to come with the end pieces, which go on like this. So notice that I installed this lip on the left side. Mm-hmm. Very important. This part does not have that lip. These are pretty loose nuts, so you can do a better job if you put them in and hold them with your fingers on both sides, and then come with the bolt. Now that I got all the parts in, I'm going to snug them down. Housing of the Z stage. And now it's coming time to install the Z stage into the machine. And for this, we're going to need our housing that we built, the Z motor assembly, which is characterized by having a lead screw on it, the two vertical axes, which are the fattest metal axes shipped in the kit. We're going to need 6 16 millimeter M3s, 4 10 millimeter M3s and 6 nuts, and we're going to need these 2 wooden parts here labeled 3B. Okay. The next step is to place the Z stage, which you've assembled already, into the machine. We're going to do it this way. It goes in the back like this. Put the electrical harness out of the way. Now this is the Z stage cap, which is going to go over the parts in the back like this and sit down. So now that we have the Z stage in the machine and the cap in place, we're going to bring the axle down through the hole in the top panel like this. It's a snug fit, so be careful. We're off a little in our alignment, but that's no problem. Come down through bearing inside. I'm going to do the other side too while we're at it. Now they're both in, not flush yet, but we'll get that in a minute. So now to get at the last part here, we have to line it up with the holes in the bottom, so you can move the stage around a little bit. You're going to find that it'll go. Alright, so my axles have pushed in, they're flush, they've gone all the way through the bottom plate down onto the caps we installed earlier. I'm going to give you a reminder view of that now so you can remember what we did. When we assembled the unit, we put these caps down here, these axle caps, and now these are doing their job of holding the axle caps in place. And I think while we're doing this, I'm going to check one more time to make sure they're tight. Wooden parts do loosen up after they've been in for a few days, so you got to check them. Okay, so they're in and tight. Now we're going to place our 3B axle caps on top of the axles to hold them in place. For this, we're going to use our 16 millimeter screws, and it's a little tricky getting our fingers in there, so I think I'm going to turn it around and do it the other way, which is I'm going to put the nut in from the bottom on my driver like this, or the screw, excuse me, and this way I don't have to try and hold the nut from the bottom at all. Thank you. hold them and tighten them. And likewise, we'll do the other side. Okay, now we have our four axle covers in place. Okay, so now we're going to install the motor, the Z axis motor assembly, and I find this is easier to do with the printer down in its face. So let's turn it over, lay it on its front, and we're going to raise the Z stage up on its axles like this to give it some room to work. And now the motor. If you want to look around this side, you'll see that the motor comes in, the lead screw comes in, and it goes into this hole and starts threading its way in. And what we want to do is keep threading it until the motor's flush, like it is there. And then it's time for our 10 millimeter screws that are going to hold it. Always go for the easiest one first to get it locked in. Notice a very important thing here is that I have the wire harness pointed in away from the back plate. The Z stage up, I have plenty of room to bring this guy in and start tightening him. So that's the first motor screw. Again, as usual, we're not going to tighten everything down until we have them all in. Second motor screw, we'll go for the one on the top here. Third motor screw, on the top on the other side. And then the fourth motor screw, put in the lower corner. Like so. Now let's rotate the printer back upright so we can tighten these up okay. Make sure you're not putting the legs down on any of the cables. Now I'm going to come in here and tighten all four of these. And as you know, I like to use a star pattern. So I'm going to go diagonally across to the other side. Pretty good snug to start with. Then I'll do the opposite diagonal. Again, I'll repeat the star pattern one last time. Check the axle cap screws, make sure they're still snug. Okay, now we're going to put a little Magna Lube, which also came in the kit, on the lead screw for the Z axis. Now do not put this grease on the X or Y axis, only the lead screw. So I'm going to put a droplet here, about like that, and I'm just going to rub it on the threads, going in the upper direction, a little bit more on the other side. When it starts to actuate, it'll spread the grease around just fine. Now we're going to align, make sure these bearings are lined up properly with the assembly. So I'm going to take this blue tape here and pull the Z-stage cap out of the way so we can do it. you recall earlier, we were using our 2.5 millimeter hex nut. So what we're going to do is we're going to give them a little bit of loose on each one. Okay, now that they're loose, I'm going to tie them one at a time as we slide it up and down to make sure we're not binding them. So I'm going to go first on this one, long end up, make this easier. Tighten one in the back. Should have left them moving just a second. No waste. Is to confirm that we have smooth travel throughout the entire length of the Z stage, and we do. The last step is to take this cable, and we want to do it at full bottom location here and feed it down through our cable duct. And that is going to be much easier if we use something to hold it open like this. You get past the boot. I'm gonna turn it over so I can grab it and pull it through. Alright, so now our cables are all pulled through. We have plenty of room on the bottom here, the cable all the way down. The last step is to attach the stage down on like this. And the way we're going to do this, our standard deal with a nut, we're going to use two 12 millimeter nuts. Okay, so the last step is to take these 12 millimeter nuts and install them here to hold the Z stage housing down. The last step of this is to put the nuts in. And for this, I'm going to use needle nose and hold it by the sides because this is a really tricky one. Lower down a little bit. Last stage is to put the nuts in here and screw the housing down to the Z stage like that. And that completes the assembly of the frame.